like, hello?
I know two things about you. One, that you never make time to have breakfast at home. Two, that you really love to eat outside. Here you go. Would you like grapefruit or orange juice?
Aren't you starting a new job today?
Yes, but Spalding offices don't open till 10, so I've got like 2 hours. Wait, can you sit? Okay. I did want to maybe take a walk around the building and go to the west side, because I know that there's that beautiful lake.
You gotta stop, please. Please, we can't go back.
I don't want to go back. I want to go forward.
And that's what I'm trying to do. Honey, it's not gonna happen. I can't let it.
I know you feel that way now. But you're gonna change your mind.
Natalia,
I know it's gonna probably take a while. I know that. Because I am hearing what you're saying. I am, but I can wait. I can wait a really long time. I'm very patient. It's not like we haven't waited before. We waited forever to be honest with each other. We waited for Frank and Rafe to be okay. You waited for me to come back. And it took a little too long. And I'm sorry, I really regret that. I know I hurt you. But we love each other. And we can work it out. I have to stick through it, and I will. So, I'm gonna leave you and let you have your breakfast. I'm gonna get ready to go find a job. But I'll eat. Because I have some raspberry preserves here, and I know that they're your favorite.
Be a papa again soon. You want to set a better example?
Knock it off, Olivia. I've had a crappy day. I don't need any lip from you.
Right. No, I was really just trying to be funny.
Stuff it.
Okay.
How much?
Cup of coffee?
Olivia?
No, I wasn't a judgment. I was just pouring myself a cup, and I know you wanted one. And you know what? The muffins are, well, muffin. The one they have left is really good here.
Believe it or not, this has absolutely nothing to do with you and Natalia or the baby.
Okay.
But Marina and Mal are breaking up.
I had no idea.
Yeah, it came out of nowhere.
Frank, I'm sorry. I thought they were happy.
So did I. Thanks.
Oh, Frank, are those all for you?
Yeah, they are.
Frank, it's 10 a.m.
Blake, I'm not drinking those now. I'm drinking them tonight. All right, right now I'm just eating a muffin and having some coffee. Is that okay?
What's up?
Marina and Mallet are breaking up.
What? Why?
They haven't given me any reasons. Or they don't want to.
Well, that's terrible. I mean, they're both nice people.
Exactly. So why don't they stick it out? Why don't they just try to figure the whole thing out? I mean,
Frank, maybe there's nothing to figure out. Sometimes people just stop being together.
But that's so sad.
I know, but love doesn't always end happy.
Love should never end.
No, it shouldn't. But sometimes it does. Where do you want to go to lunch, huh?
Holly. Oh, my gosh.
Hello, Olivia.
What are you doing here?
Well, I came here because my little girl called me.
Oh, I needed my mom.
You have seldom, if ever, needed your mom.
See, I'm writing this book about love and passion, actually lost love. And I got all gooey and weepy and sentimental, and I needed my mother. Called her.
You called your mom to talk about lost loves?
Well, you know, we are on the same wavelength because I went to see Ed today.
You did?
Ed, mm-hmm. Ed Bauer?
Oh, yeah, mm-hmm. She was married to Ed, one of her many loves.
Yes.
Of course, again, Daddy. That was, Daddy. You were madly in love with Daddy, and I spent my entire life watching that turmoil, didn't I? Mm. It's okay, Olivia can know all about this because she's in the middle of a love-life turmoil herself.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Why don't you join us for lunch? Tell me all about it.
Yeah.
We could do it here. Order room service, my treat.
You're on.
Great.
Okay, let me come here.
Well, one thing I have learned as time goes on is sometimes you just have to let it go. I mean, relationships are good, they're bad, but when they're gone, you gotta be ready to move on. It's like you let yourself become whoever it is you're going to be next. Then, of course, don't listen to me. I know nothing about relationships.
Thanks, Mom.
What?
I gotta go somewhere. Why don't you just carry on? I'll come back before the food's cold.
She always was a strange child. Your turn. So tell me about this tumultuous love affair. Do I know him?
Her.
Her? Oh. Well, so what's tumultuous about it?
I thought I met the love of my life, and then she left me, which seems to happen quite a bit. But then she came back. But she's pregnant with some man's baby.
Are you still in love with her?
I've never loved anyone like this.
Oh, my. It's amazing when that happens.
Hmm.
Of course, it doesn't make it any easier knowing what to do.
Hi. Hi, Ross. I can't stay long because I'm having lunch with my mother and Olivia. So, I'm writing a book about Jenna. It's wonderful, Ross. It's this huge, epic love story, and it's big and fantastic. And I've been thinking a lot about love lately. Probably why I called my mother. I've been thinking about the kind of love my mom and dad had, you know? Crazy kind of love. You and I had that. And then it turned into comfortable love. We had the best of both worlds, Ross. We had both. That's so rare. Oh my gosh. We were so lucky. I don't think I'm gonna get that lucky again, Ross. I don't think it's gonna happen. But I am looking forward to whatever comes next. But I want you to know, I think about you every day. I'm enough. Oh.
I was just wandering around. I saw you sitting up here, and I just wanted to, you know, check, make sure everything was okay.
I just... come here to talk and cry. Yeah.
Well, he was always a good listener.
Yeah, he still is.
And as long as he's not saying anything back, I guess you're doing all right, okay?
But he is.
What's he say?
Ed Bauer was my best friend.
No, he was the one who knew how to be a friend. Did he tell you anything today?
Well, we talked about love. And about how lucky we were to have had it.
I guess anyone who's had it is lucky.